Ever wonder, when watching video on the internet, when it goes from really blurry to then super high quality and then back down? How does that happen and why does that happen? This is usually the result of a video implementing adaptive bitrate streaming, a technology that allows video quality to adjust automatically based on a viewer's network conditions so that the playback is always seamless. And one way to implement ABR is with the HLS protocol. That is what we're going to be talking through today. And in this tutorial, using ffmpeg, of course, we're going to show you how to take an MP4 file and package it into the HLS format. So we have our terminal here. We have our input video here. You need ffmpeg to be installed. If not, you can install with homebrew. So it would be brew install ffmpeg. So there are two different ways that we're going to create HLS streams here. The first one is kind of simple. It's just using one rendition. We're just going to take the input video and output a kind of a chunked segmented HLS format. This. So I stands for input. We have our input video here. And the first option is going to be -C, which stands for codec. So this is referring to audio, video, data, subtitles, captions, any of the like. So we're just going to copy all of those over, right? We're not encoding, we're not transcoding. And so the first option is HLS_time. And we're going to set this to 5 seconds. So what this means is each segment that we're creating is at a max of 5 seconds. And of course, the last one is 5 or below. And this is just a good kind of middle ground for HLS in general. The next one to be list size. So list size is the size of the manifest, how many segments are within that. To turn that off and just have all of them, we're going to type 0 there. And then -F stands for format. And of course, we're going to have the HLS format. And then we can have the output. So this is just going to create all of the TS segments that we want. If you check it out here, we can just take a look, right? We have all of our TS segments here. Let's see if we play it here, just using VLC. Look at that. Everything's great. I have it muted here. So that's exactly what we want, right? Okay, so we have that first one done. Now we're going to get on to the more complicated one. This one includes 3 renditions. We're going to be encoding our input video into 3, which are at 1080, 720, and 480p. And this allows the player that we're going to be using to alternate between each one depending on the user's network connection. So you get all the benefits of HLS with this one. All right, so first part, ffmpeg-i, we have our input video. The way that we get it into 3 is we're going to be using a complex filter. And then we have a string. And if you can see here, it's going to be the first stream. So index 0, the video relating to that, we're going to split it into 3 different videos, program V1, program V2, and program V3. So the first V1, it's going to be 1920 by 1080. Our second one is going to be 720, so 1280 by 720. And then our third is going to be 480 at V3. Alrighty. The next one is we're going to map with V1 out, and C stands for codec. So we're doing the video codec for the index stream of 0. And we're going to be using the libx264 encoder, which is just an H.264 encoder. The bitrate of the video stream index 0 is going to be 5,000 kilobytes per second. That's our target. The max rate is going to be 5350, and the buff size is going to be 7500. So that's just for the first one. That's going to be for 1080. So the next one is going to be for that 720. Be the target bit rate is going to be 2800. The max is going to be roughly 3000, and then the buff size is going to be about 4200. Okay, we're going to do the last one for 480. So that's for the video. And now we have the audio encoding controls here. So again, we have to map each one because that's how we select each stream. So the audio stream at stream index 0 or program index 0, we're using an AAC encoder. And the bit rate is going to be 192 kilobytes per second. And the audio channels or -AC is going to be 2. So we're just keeping it at a stereo channel mapping here. And so that's for the first 1080 one. Now we're going to do the 720. So we're dropping it down to 128, right? We're trying to save some data here. And then the last one is going to be 96 kilobytes per second. Alrighty. And now on to the HLS kind of settings. All right, so the first one is going to be format. We saw that earlier. And HLS time. We're going to use 5 for this one. And then a playlist type. So you see here, they're independent segments. Segment type, it's going to be MPEG TS. That's kind of what we had before. That's the default. And then segment file name. And so the file name, it's just like a way to kind of template every single segment. And so we're going to do that using this. And so you see here, the stream underscore, and this placeholder is for the video stream or the video rendition. So it would be 012. And then the data, right? This is just the number of segment that we're going to be using. Alrighty. And then the master playlist name is going to be called master. And then we're going to map based on the rendition playlists. You see here the variable stream map. So we're going to do video as index 0, audio as index 0, so on and so forth for each one. And that's just kind of mapping all of these to each playlist rendition. And then finally, we are going to map the playlist rendition playlist to the master. And that's going to be the end. So if you see here, it's a pretty lengthy command, but we're going to hit run here and see what gets created. As you see here, it's encoding everything, whereas before we were just stream copying, so it's going to take a little bit. And it's doing all 3 simultaneously. Alrighty, so it just finished. So we're now going to take a look. So here's the master, right? So if you take a look, it's going to have all of the rendition playlists. And you can see here, it kind of, in the tags, it copied our average bandwidth or bitrate, our resolution, and the codec mine types that we'd be using for the web. All right, and so what we can do, just set up a simple server, just so we can kind of access this, you know, on the web and kind of get the full benefits. So I'm just going to copy this over, and we're going to go into Safari. So it natively supports this, and boom. So here's our master. If I hit it, right, it's going to change size based on the resolution. And yeah, and show some meaty stats here. Look at that. And that is it. Thanks for following along. Make sure to check out the link below if you want to follow this tutorial in written form. Till next time, happy streaming.